you, m'lady.
You're welcome. Hi. Jazz here. You Dr. Ting?
Going into this consultation with Dr. Ting, I am scared that he may say something bad or suggest that I do get this tissue expander.
Thanks so much.
Another consultation. I feel like it takes
the whole universe to get my procedure. Nobody has had this many consults.
We've been across the entire country.
Your special case.
I'm hoping that this consultation with Dr. Ting is the last consultation that we have. I hope to achieve some type of finality.
I think we're on the cutting edge of the medicine in this area.
I don't really like being on the cutting edge of anything.
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
Hi. How are you?
Good, I'm Greg.
Greg, hi, I'm Dr. Ting.
Nice to meet you.
Hi.
Jazz, nice to meet you.
Hi, Jazz, I love your hair.
My name is Dr. Jess Ting. About a year and a half ago, I gave up plastic surgery to focus on transgender surgery.
So just bring me up to speed. So how old are you, Jazz?
I'm 16.
And then in terms of hormones and puberty blockers, when did all of that start?
I started the puberty blockers at age 11 and hormones when I was 12. Have you worked on other patients who have been blocked from such an early age?
You were the earliest.
I do have some concerns about Jazz having this operation. She is younger than anyone we've operated on so far here. So this is a big step. You want to make sure the patient is prepared, understands what they're doing, and is making the right decision for themselves.
But I mean, you're very fortunate. Your voice hasn't changed. You look like you haven't had any hair growth.
But that's why we're in the position now, because she's got less material to work with.
That's not a problem that we can't overcome. One of the things we can do is we can put in a tissue expander, which is a skin stretcher. And we can put that in the scrotum. It's kind of like an empty balloon, and you slowly fill it up every week with just water. As it blows up, it stretches the skin, and that can create new skin.
If you start the process, then we fly back to Florida. Do we have to come back and forth, or is that something that we could do?
As far as doing it yourself, I mean, how are you with needles? Because you just have to find, there's one place in the tissue expander, mm-hmm. you have to put a needle through the skin, mm-hmm. into the expander and inject saline into it.
But that's very painful though, right?
That's very painful.
This sounds like my worst nightmare. I mean, obviously, if I need to do it to get the operation done, then I'm gonna have to do it. However, I'm really hoping that I could avoid this altogether.
How much does that affect your life, like going to school and things like that?
In the beginning, it's okay. It's not that bad, but
Once it gets bigger,
you're gonna be walking around with like the world's largest scrotum. We're talking like, you know, the size of a grapefruit.
Oh my goodness.
It's really uncomfortable.
No matter what Dr. Ting says, I am not a fan of the tissue expander. It makes you immobile. And Jazz's depression is still looming.
So besides the tissue expander being uncomfortable, are there any other complications that could happen with that?
So that's a great question. And the answer is yes. The most common complications from a tissue expander would be infection. In which case the expander has to be removed. The other problem is that the suture line can split open. You can see the implant through their skin.
Yay.
Right.
The more information that Dr. Ting reveals in this consultation, the more worried I am about this examination. I'm afraid that he's gonna take one look at me and be like, okay, you need tissue expander, you need this, you need that.
Would there be any way to like work around the tissue expander?
Well, I could examine you and we would know, but there are other options. We have this skin on the outside, right? But there's actually like a second skin on the inside of your body called peritoneum. Peritoneum is different than skin in several key ways. It's hairless, it's pink, it's also secretory, it's moist, it creates fluid. In a lot of ways, it's kind of similar to the tissue that is lining a cis woman's vagina.
Is there a limitation of how much peritoneum you have available to use?
We can get a lot.
Really?
But this is experimental. I've done it in about 15 patients.
I'm not keen on the use of the word experimental.
15 is not the greatest number, I'm thinking. Why couldn't he have said 1,500? I would have felt much better.
Out of your 15 patients, have the results been successful?
Mixed. We've had some very successful ones, a couple that were less successful. Like with any kind of surgery, there are parts of it that are just out of our control.
All right, well, I guess examination.
All right, should we go?
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay.
There's so much information that we have to digest and come to some conclusions about. But the idea of having tissue expanders is a really tough concept to grasp. I want to have Jazz have the least drastic method of obtaining the results she wants. It just seems like we would need to set aside a much greater amount of time for Jazz to be able to have that process done and then to have the surgery and then to recover.
Okay, so we're just gonna do a quick exam.
It seems like a very difficult road.
So the vagina is gonna go right over here.
I'm hoping that he saw what he needed to and that he can construct the best vagina possible based on my materials.
Now, if we put a tissue expander in, that's gonna go right over here.
I'm very nervous because the tissue expander affects me physically. It would prevent me from being able to walk and engage in physical activity, and I need to do that to lose this weight.
Okay, so we'll see you upstairs, okay?
And I have to lose this weight, or there will be no other issues to deal with at all because I won't be getting the procedure done.
Okay. After examining you, as far as a tissue expander is concerned,
spit it out and tell me if I need this tissue expander or not.
You just